We're in the throes of developing a new campus for Southwest College. It's something that we're very excited about. We're hoping to build a campus which will be world class, which will be absolutely sector leading in terms of the technology that we're using. For a good number of years now, Southwest College has been involved in the whole area of sustainability and passive house construction. The new building that we're hoping to construct, which will be there in campus, we're going to build that to passive house premium, which is unheard of. It's a new standard, it's at the very top of the tree, and this will be probably a leader in Europe in terms of construction techniques.
Passive house is originally a German building standard. It is a standard based on measuring the building physics to be very precise about how a building performs. BREEAM is the Building Research Establishment Energy Assessment Method, and it's a much broader remit than passive house. It measures the performance of your whole project based on a credit system. Our existing campus at Fairview is in Enniskillen Town Centre. The 1970s build has reached a point where the running costs are very onerous. So with these enhanced building performance standards, we're going to achieve a 90% energy generation and an 85% reduction in running costs.
Passive house is very important to Southwest College because it's a core part of their curriculum. So this building will actually become a teaching tool in itself. As the building beds in and as people use it, you'll be able to actually carry out research on how well that actually works. And that should be seen in terms of benefits to the students, natural light, great views. The air quality will be second to none, because again, it's not generally mechanically ventilated.
The new campus means a lot to Southwest College. The staff are very much looking forward to it. It's an exciting concept. We've been in this building a very long time, and a new build with all the advantages it has for staff and students is something we're all looking forward to.
The site where the new building is going to be constructed is the site of the old Erin Hospital, but there are other buildings in there adjacent to it which are very important to the region, very important to the people of Enniskillen, and that's the old workhouse.
The entirety of the workhouse building would have been huge and stretched right back to the Corngrade Road as we know it now. It's a hugely important area. It's a hugely important building. So many lives were lost at Enniskillen Workhouse. So many lives walked through those front doors. In terms of the overall plans for the site on Corngrade, I think it's crucial that it's really aiming at education, that the college is going to be there. There's going to be, if you like, new life brought to the site. But it will create an opportunity for more people who are at the site to learn about the workhouse. It's a very stark visual reminder of a time in our history not all that long ago.
Challenge for us was this is not a standard building. This is something which really breaks the barriers in terms of its plan layout, in terms of flexibility, in terms of how teaching happens beyond just the basic classroom or teaching space.
The passive house criteria do drive the design too. It has led to a much narrower long building to ensure we have cross ventilation. That's informed how and where we place spaces in the buildings. The building is 180 square metres. It goes from two storeys on the west side to four storeys on the east side of the building. And the sweep of the building does wrap around the upper level of the site. It's trying to respond to the B2 listed workhouse building adjacent. And the input of the people in the Devonish area has led to including public spaces at the top of the site.
The learning steps or stairs, which are positioned at the change of levels within the atrium. In between each of those levels, we have what is effectively an informal lecture theatre type arrangement. So you can have ad hoc sort of discussions amongst students. You could actually have formal classes, but with students from other subjects maybe joining in.
For students, it's a very exciting opportunity to access these facilities locally, so that their teaching is delivered in facilities that are world class and on par with any university globally.
In terms of classrooms, they will be modern, they'll be bright. We are future-proofing the digital aspect of education. There'll be new learning spaces.
I think this development is going to be a huge thing for the region. It will change the educational landscape for the South West region and for Mana in particular.
This is a legacy project. It's a pioneering project on a global scale.
There will be this fantastic juxtaposition of a 21st century building with a 19th century building.
I must admit, the building that I'm sitting in here now holds a lot of memories for myself, for my colleagues, staff, and for students who have attended over the past number of years. And we will be sad to be moving on, but we are excited at the same time about moving to a new campus that's environmentally friendly and with all the exciting aspects that it'll involve.